Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BUFU Gaming, and today we are back in Hammerhelm, and I know we've had a little bit of a break here since the last video, and the reason for that has mainly been that I've been waiting for Jonathan to finish working on the combat, because there's been a lot of updates in the last month or so, lots of bug fixes, little adjustments here and there based on player feedback, and fixes to quests and stuff like that. There's also a new quest actually related to Nika here, the little doggy, that we'll get at some point. And then Jonathan has been working on changing the combat so that now you don't really have this targeting system that we had before, where you could pretty much just only hit the monster that you were actually targeting, and then you had to press tab to switch to another one. But now when you're doing combat, it should be based on like a front arch in front of you, right? So whichever monster is right or closest to the center of that arch will be the one that you hit, except if you're using an attack or a weapon that has more of a sweeping attack or an AoE attack, then you can hit anything within that front arch, right? So there's been a bunch of changes, and I've just been kind of waiting for that combat update to get finished, and I think it was finished last week or something, or yeah, at least a few days ago. So anyway, let's see what we're gonna get up to today. We got the cookhouse going last time. What did I have? I did place the lamps, we have a well, we have our sewers here, so we're kind of good on those three things. All of our houses has happy people, you can see the flowers outside, so that's a good thing. So I think we're just going to try and do some quests today. We have some dungeons, we have some caves, and we need to talk to Frevin the worker and ask about Shady the goblin. Okay, let's see if we can find Frevin. That would be you. Yep, let's do that. And quest. I noticed that goblin friend of yours hanging around near town. He looked upset. Ew, okay. So we need to see what that is all about. And then I kind of noticed, I think there are some monsters over here. So I'm thinking maybe we'll go and try and see if we can deal with them. This looked like there was something. Yeah, I see a campfire way over there. We're also going to get into the dungeon, so we have that to sort out as well. That should be over there somewhere. But let's just go and try and deal with these guys, because it's definitely going to be a little bit different with the combat, I think. And now that we don't have this targeting system. What is that over there? Oh, that might be the dungeon. I can see a building over there in the back. Hey, guys. Okay, so there we go. So yeah, look at that. Now I can kind of walk to the side. I'm not kind of tied to this monster as I was before. Before I couldn't actually move around the same way, because it would try and force me to always be facing this monster. But now I can actually turn around all that I want, and I don't have to press a tab. Tab actually doesn't do anything anymore. There we go, because we're just going to be hitting anything that is within range here. There we go, and I have to remember how to do this. Yep, there's also some options that has been added, so you can now kind of double press either A or D or S to kind of get out of the way like this. Yes, I don't even remember how we could do that before. There was another key we had to press for it, I think, to roll, but now you can do that. So let's see if we can deal with you guys. I keep getting hit there, that's not so good. Okay, nice. Okay, so we got that sorted. Let's put you in there. We got some mushrooms and a little bit of money. What's the deal with these? It doesn't look like I can pick them, but okay. I like that there are some sunflowers here. So let's try and head over here and see if this yeah, that must be the dungeon that we need to get into. Ooh, let's get these. Right. Is there any? I'm not seeing any. Just wanted to see if there was any beehives or anything around here, but I don't really see anything. Nope. Okay, well, we are gonna enter the Dungeon of Curses. The Dungeon of Curses. The Dungeon of Curses seems ancient. You can hear the creatures moving about. Be on your guard. Well, the nice thing about this is we can get extra money in here, right? There we go. And Jonathan did say that he's planning on adding more dungeon quests because it is a nice way of getting money aside from doing quests and stuff, because you can actually get money from looting all these crates and stuff along the way. There we go. Ooh. I think there's some changes to how the monsters attack and things like that as well. Not quite sure, but there you go. Lovely. I have to try and be a little alert here. Let's use one of these. Make sure to get a little bit of health back. And also have to watch out for traps, right? Okay, not seeing anything. So, oh, but I do see over here. Okay. Okay, let's try and get that. Let's wait for this one. And there we go. Now I should be able to stand here. Hopefully without getting hit. And there we go. Hey guys! Mm-hmm. Oh! Sneaky! Oh, let's get out of the way there. Okay. Mm-hmm. Oh, come on. Okay, I have to remember how it is to actually roll. Oh! Okay, sometimes it does kind of... Oh, you barely have to touch the button, actually. I'm kind of pressing them a little too hard, but you barely have to touch them to do the double or double press to actually make the little roll. Okay, that's... Oh! Mm-hmm. Oh, boy. Okay, come on, guys. And... Yes, I knew it. You were gonna try and attack me there again. Ooh. Okay. Lovely. So far, so good. Okay, two monsters left. We found 82 gold. Uh-huh. Okay, let's grab that and go through here. Okay, let's see. Mm-hmm. I think there was also a change to how the difficulty of the monsters work. I think that has been changed a little bit maybe, but I don't fully remember. I've kind of been reading the patch notes as they came out over this past month, but I can't really remember all the details because there's been a lot of patch notes from all the different little changes and fixes and things, right? There we go. Because Jonathan has been really, really active, as he always is, with fixing things and, you know, changing things to try and improve them based on people's feedback. Oh no, I didn't get far enough out of the way. Oh no. Woo! I do feel like they attack more frequently now than before, but I do kind of like that because it does make it a little bit more, just a little bit more challenging. It's not really a hardcore game at all, but it does increase the risk a little bit that you might end up dying, or at least have to watch out a little bit, right, with your health. Here we go, and... Yep. Mm-hmm. Because I feel like before, sometimes, you know, they might attack you twice in the time frame before you actually manage to kill them. But now they do seem to attack a lot more frequently, so that's cool. Nice. Got some more monies, which is good, so we can get more houses. Ooh, and we leveled up. Awesome. Okay, I don't think there's anything else here for us to get, so... Leave the dungeon. And I wanted to check... this should have been updated, yes. So you can see here there's a whole lot of information about how to actually fight now. This entire menu has been updated, so you can look in here and figure out exactly how things work. There's a description of the health bars. So we have weak, strong, strong. So those were like extra strong, the ones I just fought in the end there. I think they're actually supposed to be stronger than the red ones, right? So yeah, there's all kinds of options. Dodge left or right, dodge backwards. Oh, it's shift, right? So shift you can use to dodge backwards as well. And then there's a whole bunch of other information here. This must be one of the special attacks. Yes, open special attack UI, removes any buffs on monsters, chance to stun, cause stamina has cooldown, and there's a whole bunch of other ones here. Yep, okay. Well, that one was sorted. Then we need to talk to Shady. But we also have this one. Where's the cave? The cave is over this way, so let's go this way. Mm-hmm. See what else we might find along the way. A bit of leather. Ooh, there we go. Get some fireflies. We do need to collect some of these things because we do want to get some of the decor for the town, right? So we need beehives, we need roses, we need more fireflies. I see monsters over there in the back. We also definitely need more money so that we can build things. So I think I saw another one over here, so let's just grab some of these while we are here, right? There we go. Thank you. Fireflies and fireflies. Lovely. Yes, and that's Shady's place over there, but let's try and see if we can find this cave first. There we go, got some birch tree seeds. Do have a couple of people. I think that might be related to Shady's quest, maybe. That we are gonna have to fight those guys. Here we go. Do over here. Grab this one as well. Lovely. What is this down here? Oh, that's a log. Don't really want that. I think it still just gives us mushrooms, right? Yes, because we have so many mushrooms. And not so much to use them for right now. Okay, where's the cave? The cave is this way. Oh no, Wolfbine had a bad day. That's not good. I think maybe that's the cave over there. Do see some more books there that we could. Right, but let's try and see if we can complete some of these quests, because they also do give us some nice monies, right? So, Cave of Darkness. The Cave of Darkness looks newly inhabited. The stench of evil permeates every crevice. Be wary. Ooh. Okay. Hello, guys. Okay, we're starting with a tougher one right here. There are also some changes, I believe, to how the, how the spellcasters work, for instance, how their attacks work, and stuff like that. Ooh, let's make sure to drink one of these again. Your town has run out of raw food. That's not good. I think we need to get another. We need to get another famine. There we go. Okay, get out of the way. Yes. Oh no no! Now you're coming. That's funny. That I think that's actually the first time I'm seeing that spin attack, but I kind of like that. That's cool. Definitely something to be alert about, right? So I think we came from there. So let's try and go this way. I was about to say, isn't there any ores? But yes, there are. We can get some iron, it looks like. Here we go. I don't think we have an iron mine yet, do we? Or we didn't. I don't think we've done that quest yet where we can get iron stuff. Oh, you have like a little dash attack or something going on there. That's cool. There's a lot of things that have changed since, well, at least since my last series, which was, I think, over a year ago or something. Some of this stuff was probably already in when I did the last video a month ago or something, but there we go. I just hadn't experienced it yet in this new series. There we go. Nice. Okay, so let's get this. Because we still only have... Well, we have some iron now. To make iron ingots, but we don't have any of this yet. And I don't think we have done the quest so we can actually set this up. So that we can mine iron. I'm not quite sure. Oh, look at that. A copper ore deposit has been discovered above ground. Okay. Well, we still have two more monsters left to do. So, let's sort you guys out. There we go. And see if I can get better at this. Oh, my health is actually a little bit low. Oh, he's a bit stuck over there. Oh, no, 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 no. You sneak. I think he kind of got stuck in his animation there. Oh, dear. Let's make sure to drink this. Mm-hmm. I do just feel like I'm taking more damage than I did before, but they are doing more of these special attacks, which is kind of fun. Oh, yep. I have to be more wary about avoiding their attacks. Hello, guys. Okay, that was... Okay, but that is, of course, a challenging thing when you have both of them, because one might try and attack you and then the other one doesn't, or the other one doesn't. And then when you go in to attack yourself, then the one who didn't attack before will then attack you, right? So, Hello, guys. Okay, that was both of you, so I'll see if we can get you. There, lovely. Nice. We got some more money. Wow, look at that. 794. Now I'm getting all these mushrooms again. But no, I don't want to leave just yet because I want to get all the oils that I can before we leave. Get all the goodies. There we go. Cool. Okay. So far, so good. So now that we are out again, Shady must be over here somewhere. Yes. Oh, what is that down there? Oh, it's just a campfire. Mm-hmm. From with some mobs around, of course. Any other goodies around here that I can spot? Oh, there's more birch tree seeds over here. Let's get them. Nice. Okay, we might have to go out and explore the map a little bit to see if we can find some of these more decorative, or more of these resources to make more decorative items, right? But it's not really my highest priority at the moment, because I think there's other buildings I would rather have. Like, we need more food for the town. That's very important. Okay, but let's see. Oh, there's another birch tree seed. Thank you. Okay, what's the issue, Shady? Oh, that's not where Shady is right now. Shady is over here, but then at least I found this, so that's nice. Alright, you're probably standing over here near the town, that's right. Yes, how did I forget that? That is usually the deal. Me, Shady, not like other goblins, just want to have shop. Indeed, you help make those other goblins leave Shady alone. Ooh, okay, travel to Shady's shop and confront the goblins. There's another little change that has been made, so now the leaves actually match the color of the tree. So when you have these falling leaves here, they will match whichever tree they are falling from, so that's cool. Well, let's go over here. I see a little crate. Let's break that, because sometimes you get some meat or things from it. Oh, coal this time. Cool. Hey, guys. But I have to try and deal with you guys. Yep. Okay. Okay, that was one down, but that was the easier one. Oh, there we go. Let's try and avoid your attacks. Oh, there we go. Nice. Okay, that was you guys down. Cool. Got some more leather. Lovely. I think we have some more guys over here in the bag. Oh, and I see some rose petals. That's good. Let's make sure to drink one of these. I actually also have my, special attack, but I always forgot to use that. Wow, yep, you have a shield there. Okay. Okay, let's try and get out of the way a bit, and oh, that's W. Okay, and Oh, you sneak! You actually avoided my attack. Oh, I do like these changes though. Oh, look at that, we got a goblin part now. Now we can start working on that. I think we need quite a few actually to build the display so you can make them the trophy. Now we have coal as well, used to heat homes. Cool. Okay, so let's head back to Shady again and say that we have dealt with the gubbins. Yep. And then I think we are gonna head back. Oh, maybe we'll do that little found ore thing. But other than that, I think we're gonna go back and see if we can actually build something. Thank you much! We have gold for you to take. 150. Lovely. Okay, so now that is sorted. Let's see if we can get this ore over here. Wherever it is. Oh, hello guys. Oh, they do have a pretty far reach. Actually, you have to kind of get a good deal away to not get hit by those attacks. There we go. Yep. Oh, come on. But I do like this. I much prefer this over the way it was before when you kind of were stuck on this targeting system. I was never much of a fan of that, so I really, really like that it has been changed. It feels much more fun doing the combat now. There we go. So I definitely like that. Cool. Okay, so far so good. Where is... That should be over here. Let's see if we can find that copper ore. Oh, it's right over here. So just kind of looking around for other stuff. Okay, it's a little bit of copper, but there we go. Nice. And I saw a little shiny. Okay, more of the birch tree seeds. I do see another shiny there, but let's try and head back home. It's kind of getting dark soon. And see what we might be able to get up to. What do we have? 1200. Okay, that should be enough that we can build something. I can't even remember what the next thing was I wanted to build, but I think another farm would be really important. What do we have? I don't even know what am I growing carrots, it looks like. Yep, let's see. Farm plots. Yes, we are growing carrots. We could do... Why have I not set it up for a variety of things? That's a bit peculiar. But there we go. Now we have different things. We're not growing cotton though. But now we have different types of resources coming in here. Or the different types of food. So that's something. So what do I have when it comes to food? Where's the food? Raw meat has already been used up. Well, I have a little bit on me. We do have cotton. We have a little bit of wheat. Where is the raw food? Oh, other raw food. Oh, raw veggies. We only have 20, but we do have 129 meals, so we are good on that. We don't really have any more coal. But I think we have to mine that. Just not quite sure how to get more mines. Because we still only have one, right? Which is that one over there. And if I remember correctly, we can only mine. That would be in here. Yes, change goal. Yeah, we can still only do copper. I'm not quite sure how we get on to iron, because I am getting iron. I just can't really upgrade the mine for it yet, so I don't know how we are going to be able to do that. But okay, let's go in here and let's drop off some of this stuff that we have. We have some more roses, we have birch trees, we have these. Yep, we have the meat there. We have more of the... iron, so let's just pop that in there. Then we have more mushrooms. We have more leather. Oh, nice. We can store a lot of the leather. I do like that. I do wish we could store more mushrooms, though, because you always end... See, I have 80 in my inventory, and you get so many of them. And at this point, we don't really have much use for it. Oh, I actually got something else here. What kind of... That's a different tree seed. Ew, cool. Okay. Let's see if I wanted to... craft something in here. What if I just wanted to make some iron ingots? There we go, we have 18 now. So I'm kind of thinking I want to start working on something new in here. Maybe, but I feel like usually we get, there's something about the helmet, that we usually get a new helmet or something when we kind of get access to the next level, but we already have iron. I feel like I'm a little bit confused about how to actually progress with that. But okay, we have 18. We could make some braces, could make a new weapon. Let's try an axe. Yes, let's do that. That's what we're gonna do. So damage 48 compared to 38 here. So we're gonna put you there. This I want to keep though, because I want to put it on display at some point. But see, we need to get some storage into our home so we can get rid of some of this, because otherwise we're gonna end up with this full inventory. There we go. Okay, so... we don't have... We have the cooking station. What did I have over here? That's my home. Then we have the weaponsmith. We have the stonemason. Yeah, we need to get the carpenter in, because then we can get more of these. Yes. Yes, yes. So we can start getting some furniture in here, right? So let's see if I want... Well, we have enough... We have enough meals, so we should be good on the farms for now, but I do need to get more farms. But I also really want to get people's houses sorted out. And this is the only way for me to also get like storage for my own place, build furniture for townspeople homes, reduces cost for houses if town also has a stonemason, increases the amount of handles and tools that the metal worker can craft. And it requires a metal worker shop. Okay, so it's 500, 25 woods, and 40, yes. So now we have that. We have the cookhouse. I think we're going to put the carpenter over here. Let's do that. I kind of chose to not have a road there. Why did I choose to not have a road in between? I would have thought I would have a road coming here. And the same over here. Or do I prefer having you like this? And it's kind of facing away. Don't think I want that. I think I want it like this. Let's do that. So now we have a carpenter shop. I think we're gonna need another house though, so we can get some more people in here. So that's probably a good idea. Okay, we need some more wood for that. Well, it shouldn't take them too long to get that. So let's see how we are doing on people. Because, yeah, we have one person there, we have one person there. Hard worker weak, carrying stone, scholar slow, building a structure. And we have grumpy strong, quarrying stone. I think I want to change that actually. So right now we have two carrying wood, but there's not really any of these that I particularly want to work with the carpentry. So I think we need more people. Okay, we have 5 wood. Let's go and get a little bit more wood. Probably a good idea. Structure completed. Carpenter shop. Yes. Let's just quickly get a bit more wood so we can get another house in here before we end this video. Which is suddenly getting a little bit long. There we go, that's 6 wood. And they're also carrying wood into town. So, just grab a tree over here. And because we just needed 15 at least to get the that building going right. Okay. Here we go. Let's go in here. And well, I don't think we actually needed to add it like this, but there we go. We're up to 21 now. Cool. And then we are gonna pop in here again. We are gonna see if we can build a house. Get another home. Just gonna do a wooden one. And then I had to figure out what I wanted to do here, because they were kind of, this entire area was kind of covered by the sewers and everything, right? I think even in the back here. But for now, we might just keep kind of filling this out. Oh, that's the sewers right there, right? It does mean we don't have kind of a road coming up here, but we could have a road coming there. Might end up changing how I've got everything placed, but for now, let's put you there. Let's see, we have a hard worker, Trendy, enjoys labor, gathers resources more quickly, takes better care of clothing, and needs new clothes less often. You are all good. Enjoys studying magic, but hates doing manual labor, loves to craft, and sometimes makes masterwork items. Oh, I kind of want you. Abhors hunting or hurting animals in any way, is more likely to be in a good mood. Well, I definitely want you, because I still don't have anyone with this meticulous. And then we're gonna grab you. Yes. Okay, and then I am thinking we are gonna switch some guys around. Because you are sickly and you're oaf, and I would like you to be able to make masterwork items, right? So we are gonna switch you out for who has the meticulous. That would be you. There we go. So yes, now you are back to being a worker, and now you are a metal worker, which means we can get masterwork items from you. That is cool. And right now we have 3 people collecting wood, 2 collecting stone. Yes. Okay, but we are completely out of time though. I'm not sure we have enough money for it, but we'll see next time, because I think we need to get another farm in as well. But that's the beginning. But now a lot of our wood should start. Oh, I forgot. Let's do that while I remember. We need to assign a carpenter, right? So, hard worker, Trendy, chopping trees. So you are good at gathering resources. I want you to keep doing that. You love doing manual labor. You're more likely to catch an illness though. You are strong and carry more resources, so would like to keep you as a worker. You like studying magic, but hates doing manual labor, walks and runs slower than most dwarves. I think I'm gonna turn you into a carpenter for now. Carpenters use quality wood to build furniture for your town. If you're finding that you're running out of quality wood and wish to focus on building more town structures, you can toggle the carpenter on and off with the change gold button. The bed icon will let you know whether your carpenter is actively making furniture or not. Okay, so that means our wood is gonna kind of be disappearing quickly, because now folks are gonna be getting like furniture in here, right? But that's nice, because it's gonna make them happier, so we definitely want them to do that. But of course we can always turn it off if I start needing the wood for something else. So that was it for today, guys. Thank you for watching, and as always, do take care and happy gaming.